A special court today framed charges in the 2G scam related money laundering case against former telecom minister A. Raja, DMK top gun Kanni Mori and Dayalu Ammal. The ED had charged ex-telecom minister Kanni Mori, DMK chief Karunanidhi's wife Dayalu Ammal and 16 others. Now in its charge sheet, ED had alleged that the accused were involved in the Rs 200 crore money transaction, which was not bona fide and genuine, but a bribe for grant of telecom licenses to DB Group companies by Raja. I'd like to quickly cut across to my colleague Ashish Merishi, who will break down the charges framed against A. Raja, Kanni Mori, Dayalu Ammal and 16 others. Ashish, if you're still with me right now, quickly take us through the charges which have been framed by the special court and what does it mean when it comes down to sentencing?
Well, Preeti, framing of charges is basically a technical formality where the accused is told that under which sections and on what charges he will be tried. So the trial begins since they have not pleaded guilty. The trial begins from the 11th. Now here, according to the complaint filed by the Enforcement Directorate, they had very clearly said that 200 crores started from DB Group companies, and from there on it went through Sinai and then to Kusagao Vegetables, and then finally it landed into the accounts of Kalyagna TV, which was owned by 60% was owned by Dayalu Ammal and 20% by Kanni Mori. So the DMK family actually owned this, and finally they have even though in the CBI charge sheet they have said Dayalu Ammal as a witness, but in this case in the Enforcement Directorate and the Prevention of Money Laundering Act, they have made Dayalu Ammal an accused. So here it is a very, very important thing, because all the accused, including Dayalu Ammal, Kanni Mori and A. Raja and 16 others, it has 10 individuals and 9 companies, all will be tried under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act.
Okay.
And in this, the minimum punishment is 3 years and extendable up to 7 years. So certainly, if the charges are proved, the trial begins. So certainly this is going to be a major setback for A. Raja and company.
The special court did take cognizance of the ED charge sheet, Ashish, that you've been tracking for some time now. Can you give us details on what was in that charge sheet?
The charge sheet had very clearly said, on how the money, under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act, this was basically bribe. This is also, mentioned in the CBI charge sheet that, in lieu of the license issued to Swan Telecom, which was a DB group company, was actually, given only after 200 crore rupees bribe. But on the other hand, A. Raja and others, including Kanni Mori, Dayalu Ammal and others, have said that this is a bona fide transaction. This was basically a loan given to Kalyagna TV and it was returned with interest. But then it was only done after A. Raja, when the FIR was registered against A. Raja. So certainly there is a proof, there is evidence with Enforcement Directorate under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act, where they can prove, that this 200 crore was paid as a bribe. But the trial begins now, the normal trial, the CBI trial is already on. The new trial under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act will start from the 11th. But now it is on, the onus lies on A. Raja, Kanni Mori, as well as Dayalu Ammal, as well as 16 other accused, to prove that they are not guilty now.
Appreciate you joining us, Ashish Merishi, breaking down the charges framed against the former telecom minister Kanni Mori and Dayalu Ammal and 16 others. We'll keep tracking details of the trial as it commences. Appreciate Ashish for joining us.